All right, let the suspense build. Thanks for the time to present today. My name is Brian Dixon. I'm a senior TAM with AWS, a little shorter tenure than the rest, about 2 years, supporting enterprise support customers. For the last year and a half, I've been very much involved with the security improvement program, which, building off of the prior presentation, is something that we offer to customers as a proactive service.
Nick? Yeah, my name is Nick Aufdemorte. I've been a TAM. Well, I've been an AWS employee for a little over 7 years. I've been a TAM for almost four, and I've been involved in this program for almost three. Awesome.
Yeah, so quick level, high-level agenda. So we're just going to talk through what the Security Improvement Program is, so everyone understands what it is, how to take advantage of it, and what the features and benefits are. Go over Security Maturity Framework, just to give an idea of what goes into the program, how we build our questions, and what the actual value map is for customers. Talk through the incident response process that customers face, reactive versus proactive, in terms of a response. How the SIP looks from start to finish. Call to action, we want to demonstrate some of the value and things we've seen from customers adopting and completing SIP. And then, of course, at any time, question and answers, but also at the end, we'll have time.
Awesome. All right, so let's talk about this. So the Security Improvement Program is an engagement. It's a security-focused engagement where we understand at a service and neutral partner review of what your security looks like or what your security posture looks like internally. We do this through a set of questions, a lot like a well-architected review. It's a question and answer framework based on 350 questions that we want to understand at a deeper level what your security concerns are and what it looks like today. In that, we follow, so first of all, where do we get our questions from? A lot of people ask, one, the service teams that build the services in the first place. So that's one way we do it. The next part is we've implemented AWS in the field with many customers, their security risks and understanding that. And then also we go to the industry. We deal with the NIST and CIS in order to get those questions. And in the latest framework, you can actually see where we've done some work in our purview or our recommendation, where the questions specifically line up within those frameworks. One other thing I do want to call out here is we do have five different areas that we cover. So identity and access management, detection, infrastructure protection, data protection, and then IR and automation.
One of the best parts about SIP is not only do we go through each of the five pillars that Nick just brought up, IAM through IR, we have a series of technical and best practice questions from an operational perspective, but we also talk about people, process, and technology. So like we talked about on the prior presentation, we want to understand why and how and what you're doing. Not just are you checking the boxes, but there's actually questions in the framework that help us understand what are your teams doing and is there a misalignment across the different teams and lines of business as it relates to how you're applying and actually using and doing security in the cloud. So currently this is managed in this type of workflow that you see. The benefit here is that we ask a series of questions and we can bring in a number of different teams and lines of business from each of the customer organizations that want to participate. We take notes and we keep track of all the conversational artifacts that are received and collected. And then as outputs, we give a full report output and all the details and based on the customer feedback we received, all the crosswalk between the different frameworks and all of the things that we see as gaps or risks or things that require action. So it's not just a yes or no to get a checkbox filled. It's really understanding why are we doing what we're doing and how do we do better.
One other thing I do want to call out here is that before I discovered the SIP, I was a novice in security. I'd spent most of my time in Linux and in EC2. And so this tool and getting a hold of this tool has really upped my security knowledge. So if your team wants to understand security at a deeper level, especially in an AWS world, this is a great tool to do so with over 350 questions, benefit and recommendation, and a link to documentation for every single one of the questions. This really is the golden ticket AWS security. Awesome. So the next one I'll talk about here. So one of the things we do is, as an output of the SIP document after we answer the questions is we want to score and we want to understand what your security looks like today and where we can make improvements. So one of the things that we do here is we not only break down that score individually here, but we also have an overall score so that we can focus on those areas where your team needs the most improvement. This way we can go ahead and bring it up the team, look at improving by 20 to 30 points and see where we can set goals now. And we can say, okay, by the end of the year, we want to be this. And also from the back part of that, you can also see where maybe the customer needs to dedicate resources. This is a great tool for that. Maybe a ProServe conversation when we jump into there. This is a great output to deliver that statement of work and maybe where you want to be in the end of this whole thing.
So I mentioned at the start, just looking at incident response from a reactive and a proactive approach. So we see a lot of customers that are in the reactive state when it comes to cloud security for a variety of reasons. Typically it's, well, we don't understand fully end-to-end what the outcome is going to be if we prioritize or we automate these things or are more proactive, just because there's a lot of knowledge gaps when it comes to going to, you know, security in cloud. It's not exactly on par or in parity with what you expect in on-premise. And even myself, I've been doing security and infrastructure and compliance for 15 years. Cloud is a whole different game. It's just there's a lot of different nuances and things that look different, even though they may seem the same. So the SIP really gives a lot of things in the toolbox or the knowledge base, like Nick had mentioned, that helps customers understand why are they doing things in a reactive stance? What are the things that we can help them do to learn, whether it's through workshops, game days, through events, through immersions, through specialist engagements. So this is building on the prior presentation. This really helps the TAM engage and give the customer so much value out of their enterprise support agreement, because we leverage all of the tools and all the features that we have to help that process and that experience be even better. And it really brings customers into alignment with a lower risk stance. So they're learning how to do things in a more automated fashion, leveraging automation and you know, tooling to make their processes complete a little bit faster and be able to handle security events as they happen, rather than waiting for an alert to pop and then actually taking action on different security events.
Okay. All right, this is my favorite slide of the whole thing. So what SIP is not? So first of all, SIP is not an audit. None of us are qualified to be auditors. None of us understand your level at a deep level there. And with the shared responsibility model, we just don't have hands on. And so that's one of the things we look at. So it's not an audit. It's used for an audit or for a framework. Also, AWS doesn't give you a stamp of approval that your security is great. It really is a conversation to understand where you're at and where you need to be. So that's probably the right way to go about it. The second part of this, it's not my job to sell you any more AWS. My job is to make sure that your security risks are defined and we work backwards to understand where we can address those risks. If that's an AWS service, by all means. If that's not an AWS service, then let's find somebody that we can find and see what we can do. Because my goal is, I don't care how you fix the risk, I just care that we identify it and you're successful. And lastly, I don't recommend this as a one-time review. In order to be strategic, you're going to go through acquisition, you're going to go through churn, you're going to go through lots of things. Doing this on a multi-year basis or on a regular cadence really lets you understand where your security is at and keep evolving through those different business events.
And just as an example use case, we'll talk about some metrics towards the end of the presentation. But like my customer that I support that's based out of Irvine, they started with based on the prior score, kind of middle of the road score, and they made it a goal that by the end of Q3 of last year, so they completed in Q1, that by Q3 they would increase that score by 35-40%. So they actually got the score all the way up to 75 across the organization. So they made it a mandate to start adapting and taking in these proactive services in this part of this engagement and really show that value. And it just makes their team even more sufficient so that they can do even more cool things in the cloud than break fix. So.
Exactly. All right. Let's talk about the phases of the SIP. So welcome to phase number one. You all are completing it right now. This is actually funny enough, mostly of our first call deck. So when we get into a room with the customer, you're seeing what we talk about and how we introduce them to the team or to the engagement. The next one we jump to is the baseline. This is usually 4 to 6 hours within a room with your team having the conversation. Who should be involved? I send you the question after we get done with the first call deck so you can decide who needs to be involved. Who knows these services or these areas of expertise well? And then we can have a conversation with them. Now, some customers, the 4 to 6 hours can be a blocker. Well, if that's a blocker for you, let's cut it down. Let's just do criticals and highs, cut it down, let's do 2 to 3 hours. My goal here, it's a game of inches, not miles. My goal here is to improve your security posture, even if I take it one chunk at a time. The next part I do is I take that document back after we filled out it out and had the conversation, and I strategize on your team. I look at where are some places where you need improvement. What are some things that we can do? Where are some places, themes that I'm seeing there? Is identity a problem for you? Is access keys a problem for you? Is data protection or understanding where your PII is a problem for you? And then I go back and I create an output deck for you, or a leadership deck, where we go back and have a conversation about what those are. What you scored in specific areas, where the program is now, and what average of customers are getting today. We'll talk about that in a moment for you as well. But then we go back and I give you that deck, and I also prioritize. So I give you 10 items focused on people and process. So I can give you a spreadsheet and you can go back and fix each one of the questions individually, but my goal here really is to take a look back and let's look strategic. What are some recommendations in people and process that we can make? Maybe there's a training on access keys, roles, and things like that, best practices. Maybe there's a process, a new account creation process. Maybe you need a runbook for a new account creation process. That way you secure the account before ever rolling a resource on it. So this is some recommendations that I've seen made. Maybe it's regular cadences once a month with your TAM just to talk about security items. So that's a great way. That way we can pull in specialists, other things like that. So then we come back after that's done. I fall off as a specialist. Or if I'm your TAM, we keep going. But really the idea there is I take those risks and I talk to you about which ones now. And that's my stab of what your prioritized item should be. Go back and take a look at the doc. Is there other things that we should be looking at? Is there other things that are more important to your business? Or maybe the criticality on the question is incorrect based on your business. Maybe really a low that we've identified is a critical within your business. So that's where places where we can have those conversations. Then what we do is we can bring in a specialist. I've been the person to request a specialist. Hey, I need help with security with my customer. Come to find out that's a very broad topic and a very interesting ask from the team. But think about it this way. I've now documented exactly what third parties you use, exactly what your security risk, and exactly what your compliance is. We've now shortcut all the discovery to understand, to get on the path to resolution for that risk. So once I have that documentation and that's a very secure document that doesn't leave my machine, I delete it after I'm done, by the way, with the conversation. That goes to your TAM. We send it to you in an encrypted fashion over either content portal or box in a very secure way. So that information is kept very private and very secure. Then what we do is we ask that, hey, let's do it again in a year. We've conducted the first baseline. Let's get your next baseline and then let's work on the next one. So really the idea, the output is there is a prioritized list of action items that we can then move on.
So then in terms of customer success stories, so this slide and the next slide, we could probably kind of weave together. Obviously, we don't want to quote specific customer names because a lot of this is security focused, so we don't have permission to publish this publicly. But just from some of the synopsis we've got, and this is, by the way, a global program. So this was rolled out globally as of March of 2023. And we have, I think on the next slide, it'll show the number of total SIPs. But we have very, very, very positive success stories from customers. The top SIP was actually one that I completed, and this re-architected and re-engineered how they started and did security from start to finish. It did result in adopting AWS security services, which for the company is a win, but it just helped them understand how do we do what we're doing better instead of trying to leverage all these other tools, because they were focusing so much on the silos rather than the bigger picture. And then the biggest one that I finished was this last one here, which was a large national university. The CISO was on the calls, and she was absolutely blown away by SIP. So we've had some really, really good reception, and those feedbacks also improved the program as a whole, right? All that feedback we get from customers.
Yeah, we're excited. So let's go over the next one. To date, we've run 1,274 SIPs with customers. We've received a 4.86 five-star survey feedback for all of our SIPs, but here comes the reality. The reality is the average score that we've seen across SIPs is 38.38. That's the average of all the SIPs we've ran. That's the scoring ran across. So the call to action is huge. Our customers need help with security. Go ahead.
Out of 100, right?
Yes. That is out of 100.
Yeah. Perspective of scale. Yeah.
0 to 100, yeah.
Also, I'm assuming that is since March 2023, right? That's when the SIP got there.
Oh, yes, sorry. Yes. 23, yes, thank you.
That is not correct. We've launched the program for 3 years. We've had, so since the SIM's been up. So actually, this is since the beginning of the program. Yep. Now, what we've seen is the SIP really is the most comprehensive tool to understand security best practices on AWS. The SIP increases AWS's customer speed of identifying and addressing security gaps. So let's understand your security gaps there. Yep. And then the other two is customers need a security lens to understand their own cloud security maturity, posture, and how to prioritize security initiatives. This is a great tool that if you're trying to understand whether a ProServe engagement is the right tool for you, this is a great way to get started to understand what your security risk profile is today to have a bit more data to make that decision. So that would be a great call out. The other part is request a SIP from your TAM today. This is the hardest thing that we face every day, is it's up to the individual TAM to understand whether their customer needs help with security, and then to identify that their customer has a need here and to bring us in. What we're trying to do is get customers, this is why we're here, we want customers to request this from your TAM.
So if you scan that QR code, it's live, it lets you put in your name if you want contact from the TAM, and we'll give that information back to your account team.
Yep.
So. And then, of course, tell us how great we were doing and how awesome the program is.
Yeah, and to give you some context even further, we're actually 14 members of the team. Brian helped develop the document. So the document you get in the end, the framework there, is that way. I've trained over 233 TAMs within North America. So it's probably one of my TAMs over the last year and a half. So it's probably one of my TAMs that if you went through one, you've experienced one of my TAMs.
Any questions?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Awesome.